Welcome to this graphical introduction to integer linear programming. We will be exploring some properties of all integer and mixed integer linear models and also discuss binary or 0-1 variables in a later video. In an integer linear program, some or all decision variables are required to be integers or whole numbers. If all decision variables of an LP model are required to be integer, we refer to that as an all-integer model, also referred to as pure or total integer model. Consider this LP model and its graph. Here is the feasible region. Moving the objective function line upwards, since this is a maximization problem, we see that the optimal solution occurs here at x equals 1.59 and y equals 2.73. with a corresponding objective function value of 28.65. Now, suppose x actually represents the number of laptops and y the number of desktops to purchase for a new office. Since by definition, x and y can only assume integral values or whole numbers, this is an all integer model. So to indicate that, we append the term an integer to the model. The feasible solutions are now reduced only to the point where both x and y are integers simultaneously. It follows that the feasible solutions to an all-integer problem are a collection of dots. Moving the objective function line upwards, we see that the optimal solution to the all-integer problem occurs here at 0,4 with an objective function value of 28. That is, purchase no laptops and 4 desktops for the office. Now suppose we decide to ignore or relax the integer requirement and use the best optimal solution satisfying the constraints, which we saw earlier on. We refer to that as LP relaxation. So LP relaxation simply means that we begin with an integer problem and later ignore the integer requirements when finding the solution to the problem. As a result, LP relaxation always provides an upper bound for the optimal value in a maximization integer problem. In other words, the optimal value produced by an integer problem cannot be better than that of its corresponding LP relaxation problem. That is, for a maximization problem, the optimal value of the integer problem will be less or equal to that of its LP relaxation. Now suppose x is still the number of laptops to purchase, but y is now the amount of time spent on the laptops. Because only x now needs to be integer, we append an x integer to the model. Since not all decision variables need to be integer, we refer to this as a mixed integer problem. The feasible solutions are now a set of vertical lines, showing that x must be an integer and y can assume any value on the vertical lines. So if we move the objective function line upwards, we see that the optimal solution occurs here at x equals 1 and y equals 3.2, with a corresponding optimal value of z equals 28.4. Suppose instead only y is required to be an integer and not x, then we have another mixed integer problem. In this case, the feasible solutions would be a set of horizontal lines, including this point here at 0,4. Moving the objective function line again, we see that the optimal solution occurs here at x equals 1.25 and y equals 3, with an objective function value of 28.5. Let's now examine what could happen when we round the optimal solution to the LP relaxation to an integer solution. Recall that the optimal solution to the LP relaxation problem is x equals 1.59 and y equals 2.73 with an optimal objective function value of 28.65. Recall also that the optimal all-integer solution occurs here at 0,4. Rounding down the LP relaxation solution gives x equals 1 and y equals 2, which is a feasible solution but not optimal. So as long as the coefficients in a maximization problem are positive, rounding down the LP relaxation solution will always result in a feasible solution, which, as seen here, may not be optimal. On the other hand, Rounding up to the next higher integer gives x equals 2 and y equals 3, which is not a feasible solution. Now consider this all integer minimization problem and its graph. The optimal solution to the LP relaxation problem occurs here at x equals 1.5 and y equals 2.5 with an objective function value of 19. This provides a lower bound to the minimization integer problem. That is, for a minimization problem, the optimal value of the integer problem will always be greater or equal to that of its LP relaxation. Moving the objective function line downwards, we see that there are two optimal solutions to the integer problem. One at 0.5 and the other at 2.2, with each producing an optimal value of 20. Now, rounding down the LP relaxation solution to this minimization problem gives x equals 1 and y equals 2, which is not a feasible solution. On the other hand, rounding up to the next higher integer gives x equals 2 and y equals 3, which is feasible but not optimal. So as long as all the coefficients are positive, rounding up the LP relaxation solution in a minimization problem will always result in a feasible solution, which may or may not be optimal. And that concludes this graphical introduction to integer linear programming. In the next video, I will be discussing the applications of binary or 0-1 variables in integer linear programming. Thanks for watching.